They don't dance until we live in cities. You'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how to run things. Hey, yo, what's going on, guys? And welcome back to another Black Ops Cold War. And this is me trying to get the Evo in that ending. So there. Of course I'm going to continue as Harden. Let's do this. Can I skip? We have already seen this. There we go.
It's coming too. Bell, no more fucking around. What did Perseus say? Where is he? You're disoriented, Bell. We'll explain everything later. Right now, we need to help each other. Where is Perseus? You tell us, Bell. That's what this whole fucking thing is about.
Bell, you were one of Perseus's agents. His associate, Arash Kadavar, turned on you at the airstrip in Turkey. Left you for dead.
When the plane leaves Trabzon, he's stopping in Duma. This you know. Here's what you don't know. Perseus won't be there. None of these hired guns are going to leave Duma alive. We dumped our bodies in the forest. Then we will move the weapons to Volkov in Berlin. From there, we fly to Solovetsk.
I think it's best if I just fucking mute my mic.
I have other plans for you. Perseus thinks too highly of you.
I don't want the competition.
We were there. We found you after everything went down.
Over here, he's got a live one.
The CIA reinvented you, Bell. We needed to give you a new identity to replace the old. It was Park's idea to make you MI6. She wanted that bond with you. You even picked up a bit of her accent. And we were able to utilize your language and cryptography skills as an added bonus. The bigger challenge was your memory.
The CIA's MK-Ultra program used Atlas missions in Vietnam as a template. We needed you to have that shared experience, that lifelong bond, to establish trust.
Yourself lucky. You've only had those memories for a few months. Me? I've been living with them for over a decade. Interrogation didn't work with you, but thanks to MKUltra's research, we had a backup plan. If you believed you were someone else, we could lead you to a place where you'd give everything up. I don't think so. You're still holding back on us, and we are gonna get it out of you. We have a job to do. Bell,
we've got a job to do.
Come on, we've got a job to do. The trigger phrase kept you in line, but it didn't get us everything we needed. Your innermost secrets were always locked behind a door. Bell, I realize you probably hate us right now, what we've done to you. I just need you to fully understand the stakes here. What you do right now is not about me, it's not about you. It's about millions of other fucking people. It's about stopping someone who, in the end, has no true allegiance to anyone other than himself. So tell me, where is Perseus?
Once we control the Greenlight Arsenal, We will detonate them all for the safety of Sobolensky.
The safety of Sobolensky.
This is your chance to find out who you really are, Bell. Where is Perseus?
From the safety of Sobolensky.
Sobolensky.
Sims, get Washington on the line. Everyone else gear up. We're leaving now. You made the right choice, Bell. Come on. You're still one of us. Adler. We won't let the president down.
Five years ago, NATO intelligence detected a powerful signal of unknown origin. The new signal created radio disruptions worldwide.
Not to mention all kinds of conspiracy theories.
NATO quickly tracked it to this facility in the Soviet Republic of Ukraine, the Duga Radar Array.
It's an over-the-horizon radar system. Big improvement over their old missile defense tech. It uses a lot of juice. Could be used to broadcast any kind of long-range signal they want.
Like detonation codes to every green light nuke in Europe. Where exactly is this thing?
About 60 miles north of Kiev. Between the cities of Pripyat and Chernobyl. It's nothing but thick forest for miles around.
A perfect hiding spot for Perseus.
We'll have to drop you in a little further out. No recon, no heavy support. Just a light infiltration squad.
Shouldn't be a problem. Just point the way.
Bell came through for us in the nick of time. I never doubted it.
Adler, still seeing no activity from our side.
Same. I haven't seen shit.
All right. Everyone converge on the gate. You sure you're not forgetting something, Bell?
There's nothing here. This can't be the right place.
We didn't see anything on our side either.
It's him! Fucking lied to us!
That true, Bell? You pull us out to the middle of nowhere, Russia, so Perseus can detonate those nukes? What kind of fucked up logic is that? What a waste. You actually could have done something with yourself, kid. Those nukes were for defense, not offense. You don't recognize the difference? I'd let you walk back to Perseus, but I think I'll spare you the regret instead. Why am I not fucking surprised? Time's up, kid. I guess I'll finish this job myself. You wanna load the body?
Fuck if I care. Leave it for Perseus to find.
Get Hudson on the horn. We gotta warn the president.
How many green light nukes did he detonate?
All of them, Mr. President.
Does anyone know the bombs were ours?
Materials related to Operation Greenlight were anonymously released an hour ago, presumably by Perseus. Calls are beginning to come in from across the globe.
That son of a bitch.
You and Vice President Bush are to be moved to secure locations immediately.
I want any business related to this thing erased forever. Everything. Can you make that happen?
Of course. It's already begun.
We will watch Europe burn. We will watch the Empire of the United States collapse under its own weight. A world with two superpowers will become a world with one. The Soviet Union. And if the leaders of this new world order squander the opportunity we have provided them, then they too will be replaced. Kasim Javadi fell into CIA hands. He is far too soft. I will need someone to handle his erasure. It is a shame we lost Anton Volkov. He was our most valuable GDR asset. But perhaps with the fall of the West, it will not prove so great a blow. Eleazar Azoulay perished in Cuba. We will not miss that one. His interference with our Middle East assets will be a distraction no more. The others, however, are still out there. I will finish them all off myself if I have to. Unfortunately, our key asset within the US, Robert Aldrich, was killed. Our spy ring there is still intact. But we will need to rebuild and find new leadership. The death of Major Vadim Rudnik is a terrible loss for post-nuclear Europe. He was to help shepherd in the Soviet-aligned future. Hopefully, we can still move forward without his presence there. The CIA also managed to eliminate one of Rudnik's key assets. The other two will help fill the void left behind. But have no doubt, these are but temporary losses. We are just getting started, my friend.
This is your chance to find who you really are, Bell. Where is Perseus?
From the safety of Solvitsky.
Sims, get Washington on the line. Everyone else gear up. We're leaving now. You made the right choice, Bell. Come on. You're still one of us. Adler. Right.
Так точно.
Five years ago, NATO intelligence detected a powerful signal of unknown origin. The new signal created radio disruptions worldwide.
Not to mention all kinds of conspiracy theories.
NATO quickly tracked it to this facility in the Soviet Republic of Ukraine, the Duga Radar Array.
It's an over-the-horizon radar system. Big improvement over their old missile defense tech. It uses a lot of juice. Could be used to broadcast any kind of long-range signal they want.
Like detonation codes to every green light nuke in Europe. Where exactly is this thing?
About 60 miles north of Kiev, between the cities of Pripyat and Chernobyl. It's nothing but thick forest for miles around.
A perfect hiding spot for Perseus.
We'll have to drop you in a little further out. No recon, no heavy support. Just a light infiltration squad.
Shouldn't be a problem. Just point the way.
Bell came through for us in the nick of time. I never doubted it.
Adler, still seeing no activity from our side.
Same. I haven't seen shit.
All right. Everyone converge on the gate. Sure you're not forgetting something, Bell?
There's nothing here. This can't be the right place.
We didn't see anything on our side either.
It's him! Fucking lied to us!
That true, Bell? You pull us out to the middle of nowhere, Russia, so Perseus can detonate those nukes? I had no other choice but to trust you. What a waste. You actually could have done something with yourself, kid. There's no winner here, Bell! You've just dragged everyone into the loser column with you. I'd let you walk back to Perseus, but I think I'll spare you the regret instead.
Comes the mouse.
Glad to see you still care. Mind giving me a light?
No hesitation. I always love that about you.
I'd offer you a cigarette, but you don't smoke anymore.
Thank you.
You remember my face, don't you? Соловецкий, stand by for the detonation order.
Так точно.
I think you deserve this moment, comrade.
Так точно.
I wish we could return to Соловецкий to watch it all unfold, but that chapter is closed now. We begin the next one together. You did well. And to think, after all this time, they still believe I'm Perseus. As if Perseus could ever be an individual working alone. So American. We'll need a new home now. The Central Committee will be more surprised than the CIA. Even if we made the best choice for the future of our homeland. Yet, for humanity, their eyes will be as clouded as ours once were. Come. There is still much to be done.
Green-like nukes did he detonate?
All of them, Mr. President.
Does anyone know the bombs were ours?
Materials related to Operation Greenlight were anonymously released an hour ago, presumably by Perseus. Calls are beginning to come in from across the globe.
That son of a bitch.
You and Vice President Bush are to be moved to secure locations immediately.
I want any business related to this thing erased forever. Everything. Can you make that happen?
Of course. It's already begun.
We will watch Europe burn. We will watch the Empire of the United States collapse under its own weight. A world with two superpowers will become a world with one. The Soviet Union. And if the leaders of this new world order squander the opportunity we have provided them, then they too will be replaced. Kasim Javadi. He fell into the hands of your former CIA friends. Kasim is too soft. I will need you to personally supervise his erasure. It is a shame you had to kill Anton Volkov. Was our most valuable GDR asset. But perhaps with the fall of the West, it will not prove so great a blow. You say that Eliezer Azoulay perished in Cuba. We will not miss that one. His interference with our Middle East assets will be a distraction no more. As for the rest, it was a pleasure eliminating them by your side. Unfortunately, our key asset within the US, Robert Aldrich, was killed. Our spy ring there is still intact, but we will need to rebuild and find new leadership. The death of Major Vadim Rudnik is a terrible loss for post-nuclear Europe. He was to help shepherd in the Soviet-aligned future. Hopefully, we can still move forward without his presence there. The CIA also managed to eliminate one of Rudnik's key assets. The other two will help fill the void left behind. But have no doubt, these are but temporary losses. We are just getting started, my friend.